Around the 1st of April of this year, I decided to abandon my old childish libertarian views because I realized that most of us were too stupid to handle real freedom, and I have been very active in my local chapter of Citizens Against Too Much Unfettered Freedom, or CATMUF. Winning political arguments against libertarians is easy, but not many of us state lickers know how to do it and be effective. We tend to try to use court historical perspective, lopsided statistics, and even newspeak to these lulberts to no avail. They always come back with more data or philosophy to counter it. It's a waste of time. Instead, there's a great method I like to call the against grandma argument. My grandmother is a sweet little 84-year-old widow and living on Social Security and the retirement money she gets from her late husband for his service in the Air Force during World War II. She makes out a meager living, but it's good enough for her and she's happy. Now, if these anarcho-libertarians got what they wanted, she'd be out on the streets with nowhere to go and no money to eat. She will eventually starve or die if she doesn't get her heart medication, whichever comes first. They spend so much time trying to dismantle the state and end my poor grandmother's existence. It's unconscionable and evil. So now when I get these liberty loons trying to convert me back using the non-aggression principle, I just look them dead in the eye and I say, I support your right to disagree with me, but do you think you should force my grandmother to die in the streets? Because that's what they are asking. When libertarians force down a government teat, all those who suckle from it are forced off, and little old ladies like my meemaw can't get into a tech job in Silicon Valley. They are using force to take away money from my dear, sweet old grandmammy. But what if they say yes? Well, then they're demonstrating that they are sociopaths who want nothing but the worst for your family, and you should decock them or disassociate from one's clan or kin. They want your grandmother dead. Why would you want to hang out with someone who wants your family dead? How could you have someone tell you that they want your meemaw dead in the streets and then tell them, okay, let's go play some Xbox? My God. So next time you see one of these jerks running around all smug with their facts and philosophy, just look them in the eye and ask them if they want to force your grandmother to die. If they say yes, then get them out of your life and find new friends. Preferably find your new friends at the DNC convention when they nominate Clinton for their candidate for president.